Thanks for checking out this movie review video. So this is for the 2019 film Warning, Do Not Play, and this is a Shudder original film. When I'm putting this review up, recording it, and putting it up, it is before the film is actually hitting Shudder, so it hits Shudder on June 11th, which is a Thursday. This is going up like 2 days ahead of time, so therefore, this is a no-spoilers review, because if anyone wants to watch a film, I don't want to spoil anything. But if you've already seen the film and you're finding this review, you'll understand what I'm talking about. So you can still watch this review even though it's not spoilers. You'll get it. So this was written and directed by Kim Jin-won, who did a film called The Butcher, which I think directing is good with this film. It looks good. Cinematography is good. Directing's good. Acting is quite good in this film, in my opinion. I was very impressed with the acting, to be honest. There are a few things I don't love about this film, but I would say up front that for anyone who is into, like, J-horror, that you'd probably enjoy this film. If anyone's into Korean films in general, you may enjoy this film. I don't know. But when I say that if people are into J-horror, they would potentially enjoy it, I don't want to kind of pigeonhole this as a J-horror film, because it's not. It's kind of like, the way it felt to me is like a mix of, like, The Ring and The Blair Witch Project, because it does have that kind of found footage to it. Now, part of the reason I say Blair Witch Project is because it gets referenced in the film, and it's obvious that that's an inspiration for the film. Also referenced in the film is The Exorcist, which maybe a little bit of a little bit from The Exorcist pulled into this film, but not a ton. So, just saying. The beginning of this is actually a little bit annoying, because the way it starts, it's extremely dark. It is extremely dark. Not content-wise, but actually, like, lighting-wise, it's unbelievably dark. I basically had to put my face on the screen to see what was going on. Now, those types of things are very, very annoying. It wasn't bad to the point where, you know, a movie like Alien vs. Predator Requiem is, because it's, that whole film is just 100% dark. You can't see anything going on, and it's confusing because it's quick shots, quick cuts. This doesn't do that. It's just this way in the very beginning, and they kind of get away from that then until there's one part much later on where you can't see anything, but you can hear things, but that's, that works, actually. So, just a little bit annoying in the beginning. I hate when scenes are not well enough lit that you just can't see what's going on, and you're supposed to see something, but it's not coming through. So that kind of bothered me, but you know, it was a small portion. There is a really cool jump scare early on. I thought it was really well done in this film. Probably my favorite moment of the film, to be honest, even though it's a very small part. One of the things that really stood out with that is that the sound effect used during that jump scare was very cool and very interesting and very effective. And that kind of gets to something else with this film, is I do believe the sound design of this is excellent. This is one of the better sound design films that I've come across recently. There are so many times where, you know, films are just, the sound design's fine. You know, it goes with the films. That's kind of what you expect. With this one, it really stood out as being particularly good. They really emphasize sound in a really cool way. And a lot of the sound effects that they use are very interesting, not typical for what you'd end up hearing. So I liked it. I really liked that auditory aspect of the film. The premise that's actually set up in this film early on is a very interesting premise. It pulls you in early because it is compelling. It's a compelling storyline. Now, where it goes from there, for me personally, it gets a little bit slowed down, and that's kind of one of my biggest issues with this, is the pacing is not the best. I do feel like, you know, it's like, with credits and everything, I think it's an hour and 26 minute running time, and it feels kind of long. So for it to not be super long, and it kind of feels long, it means some things probably should have been cut down a little bit, you know, maybe throw a little bit more into it. Yeah, just saying. There's something you see in this film that's supposed to be extremely scary. Based off of things that are said in the film, it's supposed to be unbelievably scary. The problem is, it isn't. Now, this is one of the issues that writers need to stay away from, of saying that something is the best, or something's the most beautiful, or something's the most scary thing ever. Things like this, you cannot do this. Just say it's scary. Say it's, you know, be more vague. You can't say it's like the most scary thing anything It's the most scary thing anyone's ever seen. You can't do that because that sets the bar like this. And let me tell you something, you're never going to reach that bar for each audience member. You're setting yourself up for failure with that. It's just something you got to stay away from. But like I said, you can just be like, oh, it's something scary. That does enough, you know, just less is more. Less is definitely more with hyping things up. You know, think about all the films out there where people say, oh my gosh, it was so scary. People went to see it and they were passing out and someone had a heart attack. And, you know, there's something like that in this film. And it's, then people see it and they're like, I don't see what everyone was talking about. Now, it's much better for people to just experience the film and make up their opinion without all that hype around it, because when there's all that hype, it's going to play worse to the audience because their expectations are crazy high. Just saying. Sorry, I went on a little long on that, but, you know. I have a hard time believing the main character would go as far as she does in this film. You'll see what I mean when you see the film, or if you've already seen the film, you understand what I mean. There are certain choices that the main character makes that don't really make sense for where their life situation is, what they would really be doing, and who they seem to be as a person early on in the film. Now, maybe that's kind of a point of they kind of change as a person throughout it, but it didn't feel right to me. It felt a little bit off. But, you know, it's a horror film. You got to get to the horror somehow. There's some quite creepy... Oh, I already talked about the sound design, but I wrote down that it's very creepy and effective. I mean, sound design, excellent. There's some meta foreshadowing that happens about the film when some characters are kind of talking about it. That's one of the things I did kind of like about this, is they throw some very meta stuff into this film. So it's not a very, it's not a straightforward film. It's kind of like turns into like a film talking about a film being a film. You know, it's, if that sounds kind of confusing, it is a little bit, but you'll understand if you actually watch the film. You'll get what I'm talking about. It's like quasi-horror Inception in a way. That doesn't really spoil anything, don't worry. There's a moment I actually did not really see coming in this, where things actually really ramp up. It's probably about around the 1 hour mark of the film, so there's like, I don't know, like 20-some minutes left at that point. I would have liked that, you know, to get things moving a lot more a lot earlier. But I think a lot of that has to do with being a lower budget film. You know, these Shudder original films don't get a ton of money to do what they're doing. So for that reason, I am impressed with certain things like the directing and the acting and the cinematography and the sound design. So expectations, like, you know, you need to understand what type of film you're really watching. This isn't a big budget film. It's totally not. So when you view it through that lens, there are things that really stick out. Another thing that actually really sticks out too is the gore and the violence when it actually happens. It's more sparse than you would want it to be, but you have to understand that that's because it's a lower budget film. But when they do it, it's effective. And I think a part of the reason for that is the way they choose to shoot it. It's not unbelievably explicit or anything, but between the actors actually selling it and the way they shoot it, it's effective. It is nicely done. It's definitely J-horror, as I suspected. But like I said, it's not straight up. It's not straight up. So I don't want to pigeonhole it like that. Like I said, it drags a little bit. That's probably my biggest problem with it. The other thing I need to say is when I rate this, you need to understand that I am not a huge fan of J-horror films in general. I'm also not a huge fan of found footage. So when I say there's kind of a Blair Witch aspect to it, there's a little found footage to it. And I'm just not a fan of either of the genres, really. So for the fact that I actually kind of enjoyed it is a good thing. I mean, it speaks more, you know, so just know my biases is what I'm trying to get at. The title, one of my biggest problems is the title. I hate the title of this film. I think it's awful. I understand why it's called Warning. I don't understand the do not play portion of it. I think that should have been left off 100%. I don't even think it should have been called Warning, though. I just think the title was very poorly chosen for this. Now, after I say that, that might not be the fault of the director slash writer of this film, because it's a film coming over from South Korea. You know, it may have a different name originally in Korean than it does in the United States. A lot of the times when films go from one country to another, they actually totally change the name of it. They don't just translate the title of it. So I don't know what the situation is there. I just know that whoever picked that title, it's not good. It's really not good. And I understand why, like what it refers to and why it's called that, but it's not good. So, you know, they needed a better title. That's a minor thing. There's a component of commentary on the pressures of filmmaking and the expectations of filmmakers, especially if they've done something noteworthy before. So I like that kind of subtext commentary situation going on with it. And it's kind of another aspect of what I was talking about, being meta about things. So it's very meta about filmmaking. It has filmmaking aspects that they talk about in the film, and then the overall, you know, meta and metaphors in the film are about filmmaking itself. So it's kind of cool because it's a script writer, director making a film about frustrations of being a scriptwriter director making a film, in a sense. So I like those types of things when they're done. There's also an exploration of writer's block and kind of the lengths that some people will go to kind of solve that. Obviously, in a horror film, it's going to be taken to the nth degree. It's not going to feel very realistic, but that's because it's a horror film. You got to get the horror somehow, and that's at play here. Horror movies as a personal release and a sort of therapy is talked about briefly in this, and that's when The Exorcist is specifically cited. I like that little aspect of it. It's just a cool moment to kind of connect with horror audience and be like, hey, you know, me as a director, writer, like, I'm like you people. Like, I have these same feelings, and let's nerd out about it a little bit in this little scene of the film. So I like that little touch. So, that's kind of all I have to say about the film. I can't say that I would go out of my way to recommend this to people, to be honest, but part of that could because of some of my biases, as I said. But I think there's some really good things, like I talked about in this. You know, I'm not going to repeat them again, but yeah, there's some good things. So, out of 5 stars with half stars in play, I'm going to give it a 2.5 stars because I'm so in the middle on whether I would really recommend it to someone or not. And like I said, there could be some biases. I thought about giving it a 3, but it feels more like a 2.5 to me. So honestly, I'd just say you make up your mind, watch it and figure that out, because it's hard to know. You know, these are all just my personal opinions. Everyone has their views on film. So it's just, you know, figure it out for yourself. Every movie is worth watching just one time just to know what it was all about. So I'll just say that. But anyway, thanks for checking this out. Real quick, if you want to put some comments down there, we can talk about this film. We can do spoilers in the comments, so let's go ahead and do that. If you want to talk about it or, you know, bring up anything else, go ahead. Do me a quick favor and hit that subscribe button, because that is the best way to repay me. It's totally painless for you, literally takes a second, and it means a lot for my channel growth, and I appreciate that. If you've already subscribed, hit that thumbs up just to let me know you're still watching. And if you have subscribed or you're going to subscribe, make sure you hit the notification bell. And that way you know when I'm putting up new reviews, or I do unboxings here and there, or I'm doing a live stream, because I'm doing live streams now too. And those have been a lot of fun. But regardless, thanks for spending your time checking this out. And I appreciate that. And until next time, keep it brutal.